From Starfire Sports Stadium in Seattle, Washington, it's the fifth and final round of the 2019 America's Rugby Championship, with the United States squaring off against their northern rivals, Canada. A warm welcome to our viewers, wherever you're joining us from around the world. I'm Dallin Stanford, joined in the booth for this one by Rugby Canada's Brian Kelly. And what a busy couple of weeks it's been in North America with the USA Sevens tournament in Las Vegas recently and the Canada Sevens kicking off this weekend in Vancouver. Brian, the United States two-time defending champions in this competition. And with that target on their backs, it's been a tough ROC for the Eagles and for Canada as well.
Yeah, both teams having some tough losses in the early first four rounds of the America's Rugby Championships. The Eagles just getting off the bus there at Starfire Sports Stadium. They're looking to avenge last weekend's 32-25 loss to Uruguay, as well as a tough loss, 45-14 against Argentina. And we all know Argentina 15 last weekend wrapped up the ARC competition with four bonus point victories, lifting the trophy at West Hill Stadium last weekend. But there's still plenty to play for here tonight. National pride on the line, as well as it's the last opportunity for these sides to put their hand up for selection. We all know what's coming later this year, the 2019 Rugby World Cup.
Canada began their campaign in South America with two narrow losses, one at the boot of Josh Reeves, giving Brazil a famous victory, and then a final minute penalty kick giving Uruguay the win. Well, they did well against Chile, 56-0. They also produced some fantastic moments against this year's champions, the Argentina 15, eventually losing out by 16 points.
Head coach Kingsley Jones spoke after this game. He was really pleased with his side, how passionate they were. Although it didn't go well right off the bat with an opening try for Argentina 15 off a block kick, Kyle Bailey opened the second half for Canada, getting his side back on it. Check the smile on his face here. The first ever men's player from Prince Edward Island. And then a beautiful showcase of pace here from Markham, Ontario's Andrew Coe, taking a nifty feed from Nick Blevins and running the length of the field. But unfortunately, Argentina 15 were victorious at West Hill Stadium last weekend.
Meanwhile, the USA on the road, well, they ran in 11 tries against Chile in South America. Round two, they met a brilliant Argentine 15, which saw the Eagles lose for the first time in AOC history, leaking in 7 tries. Their home clash round three was also a very tight affair, Brazil almost causing a massive upset. And then despite a hat-trick from hooker Joe Taffetier, it was Uruguay, as you see here. They're providing stiff competition for the United States. The maul, though, working superbly for the Eagles. And the benefactor there, the hooker, setting all sorts of records in the number two jumper. It is really a set piece that they've worked well this season with Gary Gold's troops. And you see another try here. Ball held at the back nicely. And Taffetier just peels away. He got three in this game. The backs were involved as well. And it was Cam Dolan out wide. We've seen him so much in Major League Rugby, getting a beautiful one-handed flick to Blaine Scully. It wasn't enough as they went down, though, 32-25.
Well, the fans are rolling in here at Starfire Sports Stadium, just south of Seattle in Washington, as you see on your screen there. First meeting was in 1977 between these two sides. In the last couple of years, USA has won all three matches. They've had a couple of impressive campaigns in the ARC, winning the last 2 years. Canada, not so much, finishing third, fifth, and fourth. As we bring up the all-time record between Canada and the United States, Canada with a 38-20-2 record dating back to 1977, although it's been all USA since the Rugby World Cup qualifiers in 2013. That's 6 years. Canada not able to defeat their North American rivals. Taking a look at the Canadian roster, three changes for head coach Kingsley Jones. Luke Campbell returning from a knee injury that he suffered against Brazil down in South America. The ever inspirational Phil Mack returning at scrum half, and a late change for Canada, Kieran Hearn not available due to an injury last weekend against Argentina 15. Ben Lesage pulled from UBC school duties in Vancouver. He slots in at outside center. Nick Blevins moving to inside center, and plenty of firepower in the back three. Theo Souter, Kainoa Lloyd, and Andrew Coe.
For the United States, well, head coach Gary Gold has made four changes from the side that lost to Uruguay last week. Ben Landry comes in for Nate Blakely at lock. John Quill recalled back on the flank, replacing David Tamalau. Sean Davies in the back line, back in number nine, with Rumah Dahar switching to the bench. And Will Hooley, he's out this week due to HIA protocol. So Marcel Brachy moves to the fullback. Captain is Blaine Scully for this one, earning his 46th cap tonight. course, look out for Mikey Tao on the left wing. Very dangerous. And here come the teams right now for this rival clash onto the field in the Pacific Northwest. Canada in their familiar red and the United States in blue. Super exciting one, PK.
Absolutely. Whether it's hockey, whether it's soccer, whether it's rugby, anytime Canada and USA square off, you know it's going to be a thriller.
The United States getting ready and Canada for the anthems. And we're going to go field side in just a moment for those as the crowd get ready.
Please remain standing and join us singing once again of the national anthem of the United States of America.
It's test match rugby, the best 15 from the United States against the best 15 of Canada. And that's what makes these clashes so exciting. These teams have met three times in ARC history. 2016 in Dale Diamond was the USA that won 30-22 in Round Rock, Texas. And then Swan God Stadium in Burnaby, British Columbia. The US went out 51-34 the following year. Last year at Papa Murphy's Park in Sacramento, the U.S. won 29 points to 10. And now let's go down to Alex Goff, who is sidelined tonight for our match conditions.
Well, guys, March weather in the Pacific Northwest, known to be varied and unpredictable. That's exactly what it was like today. Snow and rain and wind, but that's all cleared up. It is a bright, clear, crisp night. It is 39 degrees, but it feels a lot colder than that. 4 degrees Celsius for you, Brian, but it's going to be very chilly all night long.
Yeah, well, we're lucky we're in the warm booth here, Alex, so thank you for being on the sideline tonight. It's Canada. They're going to kick off. Our referee for this one is Pablo De Luca from Argentina. He has the whistle, the youngster. He's assisted by Scott Green and Denny Russell. And David Audrey is our TMO for this one. all in readiness for this clash, and great to have a Canadian voice with us on this call too.
Absolutely. Should be an exciting contest here today. Both these sides looking to end their ARC campaign with a big positive result.
It's match 61 between the United States and Canada. It comes down to the US in blue, and Mikey Tao skips the first tackle. The final edition of matches in the 2019 America's Rugby Championships. First touch there for hooker Joe Tafate'e. 273 pounds of muscle. Ben Landry joins this ruck with a white scrum cap as Davies pills it to
Molly
the back.
Inside.
Box kick coming
No.
Just outside the 22, so he's got to keep it in field. This one taken by Theo Sorda. Does well, the fullback, and then hit by Landry, the 22-year-old fullback. Ducking down low there is the captain, Lucas Rumble. All over the top, Brachy comes in to collect. Knocks it back, still in the field of play. Canada come through, but Brachy gets to his feet. Tackled there by Kanoa Lloyd. Big solid unit in the number 11 jersey. David Anu'u, 19 years young, starts in the number one position.
Hold!
Davies yet again.
Is it?
The aerial battle, this time towards the touchline, will bring up the first line out of the game.
Well, an excellent kicking attack there from fly half Gordon McRory. This is the first test match for him since the Rugby World Cup 2019 repêchage win over Hong Kong. The first choice 9-10 combination, Phil Mack along with McRory. As we see the kick downfield, Brachy has to be quick as Ben Lesage is on him quickly. Canada looking to pin the USA deep early.
Benoit Perforo, 22nd appearance. They knock it down nicely. Phil Mack, home ground advantage for him as they take it up through Nick Blevins. Canada keep it through Cal Bailey. He debuted against the United States at Dale Diamond in Austin, Texas. Perforo getting involved yet again. Forwards working in tandem. First touch for Justin Blanchett. And from Montreal, now behind the back boards. Quick hands. That's Blanchett in the pitcher now with the scrum cap, in fact.
Thank you.
Bailey involved earlier. Canada on attack. Over the 10 they go with Rumble. McRory gets missed on this occasion. It's a big contact. Ferocious stuff as Lasique comes in as well. McRory shifts it away. Sorda. Good touch there. Matt takes it to the line. Strong contact yet again. Canada doing well with possession, building the phases. And now it's a beautiful run. Looking to come in on the right wing. Andrew Coe involved. The 22-year-old, but they concede a penalty.
Well, an exciting line break there from fullback Theo Sauter, but can't quite make the connection on the offload. Canada enjoying over 3 minutes of possession early on, but Sauter dinged for being off his feet and playing the ball. But I think Canada would be pleased with the start here in the opening half.
Chance for Flaff, Will McGee to put the US downfield. McGee playing in Major League Rugby for the Glendale Raptors. 24 Major League Rugby players involved. And look at Sean Davies not looking good there, the scrum half.
I will give you time, so let me know when you're ready, okay?
Early knock there for USA scrum half. Of course, they have Ruben de Haas on the bench. Started last weekend against Uruguay.
Thank you. Don't close the bucket, they got red.
4 minutes gone, it'll be tough if they lose Davies straight away. Tafate'e.
Wait.
Man from Vallejo, California.
If you close it again, I will free kick you. Okay? This is your mark. No. I'm the referee here, okay? This is your mark. Stay there.
Well, just reminding us who is in charge of this clash. Dolan. The tall timber, the veteran. 44th appearance for the United States tonight. They set that mold. Davies seems to be okay. John Quill, the man from Cork Island, playing with Rugby United New York this season. Gets it away. It's the missile, Paul Lasica. Tafate'e loops around, gets a nice bump. And then Canada have pinched this.
Release tackle!
Excellent work at the breakdown. Mack wants to get in. Turnover for the men in red. McGrory behind the back ball.
Back.
Knocked down backwards. Sorter comes to tidy up. He's out there by Andrew Coe. Little messy. Still just outside the 22. They keep it in hand to Canada. Now Matt goes back to McGrory. Low driving kick.
Fight.
Goes down the middle
fight.
Of the field. Captain Blaine Scully's there. Advantage. Collects this. Scully, the Cardiff Blues in Wales, goes across field. Draws a couple of players with him.
Number
and no
five.
Advantage coming. Offside play.
Offside.
Penalty against offside. Kyle Bailey in the midfield. Of course, Canada kicking downfield. The players have to retract and not run up until they've been put onside. This will give USA a chance to split the uprights, get the first points of this game, if they can be successful off the boot. As we see on the replay here, that ball kicked downfield just off your shot there. Kyle Bailey running up, a little too over-anxious on that one.
Gives a chance for first points in this game. Will McGee, originally from London in England, a 27-year-old. McGee likes a strike, he turns straight away. It's 3-0 to the United States against Canada. And first points for Will McGee. Canada restart through the boot of Gordon McGrory. Goes to Brachy inside the 22. Brachy usually
release
seen
red.
On the wing, now featuring the fullback position.
It's inside.
Mack complaining there to the referee. Such a vocal scrum off. Played on the Sevens World Series for many years and now with the Seattle Seawolves going up against Olive Khalifi, who's on the US side. That one's been claimed by the United States. They do. Initially well off the kickoff, but knock it on.
Well, not the distance on the box kick, but we'll pass it down to our sideline reporter, Alex Goff.
Well, guys, it is very cold, and we were talking about how chilly it is on the side of the field. That's going to affect the ball handling, especially the outside backs. Those cold hands, difficult to get a good handle on that ball. We're seeing a couple of mistakes already, but it's really the collisions. Every single massive collision between these two teams hurts just that little bit more, and you've seen a couple players already slow to get up. Because it is so cold, it just hurts a little bit extra. Back to you guys.
First scrum between these two sides.
Let's
go, see who's got the advantage here. Ball in favor of Canada in the hands of Mack.
Up front, the experience, Hubert Bidens for Canada, 37 years of age, in his 52nd.
57 caps, I might add, Dallin.
Yeah, 37 years
there you go.
Of age, yep. That's exactly what I meant. He knew what I'm talking about.
As you can see here, collapsing right off the back. Mack not able to put it in right away. Getting a chance to reset
Coach.
Here early on. 8.5 minutes gone in the first half.
Bind.
Tight end prop there, Cole Keith for Canada. Just 21. Going
Set.
Up against David Anu'u and Paul Mullen. Paul Mullen with the Houston Sabercats. He's in three. Clean ball for Canada as McGrory floats it. Skip pass outside. Sorter. Stutter step. Just outside the 22. Canada steam it up. Luke Campbell. Made his debut against the United States in Sacramento last year.
No problem. Stay there if you want.
Slow ball for McGrory. So takes Connor Keyes forward. And his 13th appearance tonight. Looking for a loop around miscommunication. They do eventually pick it up, and Lesage has it. Well tackled, though, by John Quill. Just outside the 22. It will be a penalty for
you.
Canada. Decision time here for Phil
first.
Mack and his troops.
First thing first, you must roll away. You must roll away. No.
Well, John Quill there trying to roll away from the tackle, as you can see here, holding up Ben Lesage, who's put himself in an awkward body position, just trying to get free. referee DeLuca penalizing the Americans, giving Canada an opportunity to kick to touch here. Driving for a line-out now, hoping for the first try of this game.
The line is their mark. So
sided against the three-point opportunity. Piffero needs to be accurate with this throw. Played in the Rugby World Cup 2015.
The ball is in the front.
The ball is set. Driving for the line. It's Canada.
Advantage.
They have advantage. Collapsing from the United States. Mac tells his forwards to clear the lines. Canada knocking on the door. Blanchett. One of four players captain 2019 for Canada. They claim to be over. So knock on, but no advantage.
Well, Canada knew they were playing with an advantage there. Phil Mack had to jump in the breakdown. Not quite enough support. Number eight, Luke Campbell, knocking that ball on in the breakdown, but Canada coming back to the earlier penalty. Captain Lucas Rumble having a quick chat with Gord McRory. And electing to find touch and resetting once again.
Thank you. Now the line is the middle, okay?
Big start here for Canada. This is what happened just moments ago. Getting pulled down. They will try it again. It goes down to Blanchett. This time in better position for the line. Canada! Just short. So Mac wants to dig this one out. Chance of USA in back play as Canada look to punch one in. Still there with Mac. Bidens. Defense holds strong as the forwards move around. Campbell now the number eight.
Release Lou!
We knew it's going to be a physical battle. Hamase seems to be in the way there.
Use it red! Captain, captain.
Now Mac goes a little wider.
Release Blue, thank you.
Looping around, trying to get the low on the east one. Cole Keith in there. Phase after phase. Bidens gets put down. It's a great goal line stance so far from the US. Mac trying to get them offsides. Bailey driven backwards. Man who plays with the Nola Gold. Very familiar with the US players. Ball to back there with Blanchard with a white scrum cap.
Red.
3 to 4 minutes of sustained pressure here from Canada. What will it result in? Lasique in with a tackle. As Mac looks to snipe around. His claims of a high hit, but the halfback ducking low into it. Canadian international number 371 is Phil Mack.
Thank you.
Controlling things around the breakdown. Long passage off play. Beautiful pass. It's Mack that sets it up. And over the line, Nick Blevins scores the first try in this game. It's delight for Canada.
Well, that's the start Canada was looking for. 12th international try from the man from Calgary, Alberta. That's Nick Blevins, Rugby World Cup 2015 veteran. Such an inspirational center. That was almost 20 phases there from Canada. USA's defense holding strong on their line, but a big looping miss pass there from Mac. Trusting his inside center, knowing that he's going to be there. Not able to make the tackle there. Will McGee and Canada crossing the whitewash and taking the first lead of the game.
Just vision there from Mac, spotting the distance out wide. The forwards have done all the hard work. Conversion successful from Gordon McRory. And it gives Canada their first lead in this game. 7-3. Just over 13 minutes played. And it's the visitors that go up.
Well, Canada will be pleased with that set of phases. Slow, although some of them was slow ball, just working the fringes, A, B, C ball right around the breakdown, And their work has paid off.
Deep kick there, taken by Ko. Beats a couple of players, still goes. Canada find themselves inside the 22.
Wait. Hold. Good.
McGrory off the boot. Goes to a similar place as last time.
Stop
down.
Five.
The center of the field is McGee. Shapes up to return with interest.
It's okay.
And Theo Sorda calling a mark, so he'll have possession inside the 22.
Despite being only 22 years old, Theo Sauter has all but cemented himself as Kingsley Jones's number one fullback. It's been a long time since anybody has pushed Matt Evans, 2011 and 2015 Rugby World Cup veterans, out of that spot. But he's a real bright future for the man from Vancouver.
Doesn't kick it out on that occasion, though, so it gets a chance for Bryce Campbell of the United States to counter. Campbell does well. First touch for the outside center. And from Indiana, Landry. Great carry there from Big Ben Landry. McGee on the front foot. Taufatea gets missed on this occasion. Behind the backboards, Barachi off the shoulder. He's knocked out on because he's been caught by his teammate.
Well, the USA players cheered on by this home crowd here at Starfire Sports Stadium. But unfortunately, a forward pass is the call. Some exciting play there from the Eagles. Canada up to the task on defense. Over 16 minutes gone here. On the replay, this ball out the back. Lasique finding Bracky. Took his eyes off the ball just momentarily. Notice two Canadian players right on Lasique right away.
Well, that's right, Brian.
Coach!
Oh, missile running like Paul Lasique. You need to put 2 to 3 players on him, the 28-year-old with the Harlequins in Premiership Rugby in the United Kingdom.
We need to hear.
Scrum for Canada. Matt gets this one out cleanly. Good set piece for them, and they will honestly be working well. Also, Sorda.
All of you, stop! Right.
Puts this one up high for Teo.
Advantage.
Mikey Teo returns his kick to McGrory. No advantage coming, so offside off the kick.
All the players
have to
stop. No, you need to stop. You're all going.
Second
all
penalty
wrong.
Off the kick chase for Canada. Referee saying all the players are offside. Clearly not waiting until the chaser puts them onside. Big missed opportunity there for Canada. Now USA will kick deep into touch.
They never stop. They go
McGee
forward.
Opts for the sideline, gets his team a lineup. Let's go on to Alex
and
Goff. What's your go for us, Alex?
Well, guys, we're probably going to go see a line out in Mall here after this penalty kick to touch from Will McGee. And the Mall has been working really, really well for the USA. And the key to this, Joe Taufatea, he knows when to peel off. He knows when this Mall is stalling. And he bounces off the back, goes for the line.
Here they go. They set it up. Landry was the recipient in the line-out. And Taufatea has it at the back. You can see him holding on.
Not lost the mind.
Still driving and he peels away. Taufatea looks for the corner, is in! He's got his 19th try and he extends the record for front row forwards. Number 2 has 1-9.
The man cannot be stopped. Joe Taufatea peeling off the blind side, fending off 2 tacklers. And the USA have retaken the lead here. The man scored a hat trick last weekend against Uruguay. As you can just see here, so much patience at the back of this driving ball, peeling, fending off Phil Mack and touching down in the corner.
No, I'm okay, thank you.
Getting this home crowd fired up here at Starfire Sports Stadium. Currently playing with the Worcester Warriors over in England. Made his debut against South Africa at the Rugby World Cup in London. Such an inspirational player for this Eagles side.
And he overtook Todd Clever's record of 16 tries in 76 tests. The man, Joe Fatee. Remember his name. On his 22nd appearance for the Eagles. 1 try apiece. And Flaff, Will McGee, looking for the extra 2. He'll pull that to the left-hand side. And so 8-7 the scoreline right now in favor of the United States, thanks to their first try by their hooker.
Well, we knew going into this one there was going to be a tight game between these two sides. It always is. Both teams trading tries early on here. Canada will need to make sure that their kick chase stays on, because all of Canada, or all of USA's points so far has been after the chase has been penalized, giving USA an opportunity to kick for territory or for points.
McGrory goes down to Chamisese. Hanko Chamisese rumbles for the first two, wasn't held, able to get up, and then Mack knows to take him low. So many great runs from him as the try scorer. Tougher to end. Takes it up as well. Played with Belmont Shaw in Long Beach, California for many years. Come through their youth program there. They've now 400 young kids playing the game there.
Hold. Just that.
Davies needs to be better. That one has come off the head.
Go back. Go back.
Collision there. Play on. United States with Lasique. Teo. Can't get free. Good strong tackle coming in from Blevins. And now Lasique goes out at intertouch.
Well, there's a lot of attacking threats here on this USA side. Canada cannot make these mistakes when you've got the likes of Mikey Teo and Paul Lasique. Excellent tackle there from Nick Blevins. Lasique trying to snipe around the fringe, but Andrew Coe up for the task, wrapping his man into touch.
Good.
Perfect. Yeah, potentially thinking he had a bit more space to move than the inside center. Canada, though, with Piffero. Short lineout. They do well at the top with Bailey. Sniping run there from Mack. Tafatea returns the tackle on the halfback. But now somebody has to dig this one out.
Advantage.
Strong there from Connor Keyes. And they've lost this one, so turnover.
Well, a sloppy breakdown there for Canada. Mack not given the platform to really set and get his forwards going as that ball is called for a knock-on. An excellent attacking platform here for the USA. Just over 40 meters from Canada's try line now. Over 22 minutes gone in the opening half. As we catch the replay one more time, Mack taking this ball into contact. Bodies everywhere. Slow ball once again. Cole Keith having to clean that one up. Luke Campbell spinning that one out as we see a great shot of the steam coming off the scrum here. Cold conditions, as you've heard. These bodies are working hard.
United States have this one back with Cam Dolan, but Canada come in with a massive scrum.
Well, that's the effort that Canada's forward pack needed. As you can see, the boys coming in and congratulating the Big Eight for getting the job done, winning against the head. And USA penalized for illegal scrummaging. So penalized around the breakdown, but answering the call, and see the big shove here from that front row of Hubert Bidens, Benoit Piffero, and Cole Keith. Seeing from the side that it came out, but kicked back in from the flanker, which is of course illegal. Now Canada just outside USA's 22.
Massive effort from the pack. As the head coach Kingsley Jones looks on. Just over 350 starting caps for Canada against just over 300 for the US. Experienced team. They take it in the traffic with Nick Blevins. Rugby World Cup 2015, playing in three matches. Inside the 22, the US have turned this around, playing the ball on the ground, holding on to it. There's no complaints there, Blevins.
Well, Nick Blevins trying to plead his case to referee Pablo De Luca. John Quill with the poach, but give the credit there full to Hanko Hammerscheiss. You just see the tackle coming in here from the big number seven, just holding Blevins up and turning him, not able to turn and bring the ball back to the Canadian side, giving Quill the opportunity to poach that ball. USA able to clear just over the 40-meter line now.
United States, the rivalry with Canada. Well, when they play away, they win 24% of the time, but at home, 54%. So certainly helping their cause here historically. Knock down though, steal from Canada. Brilliant work there. Benoit Piffereau has possession. They run about the halfway
line. Release Ackley!
25 minutes gone in this first half. Rumble around the back to McRory. They go wide. Blanchett into the line.
Advantage.
Ball is available there. It's spilled free and
knock on red.
Couldn't hold on to that.
Knock
one
on
was Nick Savetta, the tall timber.
Canada just a little sloppy around the breakdown, not able to hold on to that pill. As you see this missed ball out to Blanchett, tackle coming in from Lesique, tried to get up and keep going once again, but ball spilling free. Now we're going to have a midfield scrum here for USA.
I certainly like the attempt to take it wide and bring more players into the game, because they are some danger runners as well. But as you said, breakdown needs to be controlled a bit better from the Canadian side. It gives an attacking platform for the US. They got options right and left. Big Paul Lesique is on one side. You've got the danger runner, Mikey Tao, on the other wing.
Set.
Last time, Canada destroyed the US at scrum time. This time, a bit better. As McGee loops around, that's a flat ball to Bryce Campbell. Brucky is there to help out with Cam Dolan. Now Landry. Cafetere, quick ball to Anu. Anu'u in support. And then so getting all over this one. Rumble looks like he was in there. Lucas Rumble, the captain, pulls it back for his side.
Well, the man from the Toronto Arrows, captain of this side, as well as his MLR club, Lucas Rumble, getting the job done. Johnny on the spot there, grabbing that ball at the back of the breakdown. And both these sides just passing this ball back and forth through penalties, giving McRory an opportunity to send this ball deep inside USA territory. We'll get a glimpse of this replay here in just a moment. Into contact there is Anu'u. Rumble, excellent body position right over the ball. Both hands on it, clear release. That's excellent stuff there from the captain.
Six.
Piffereau. Right about the 10, and stolen though by the United States. So trading lineouts here. Nick Savetta has it, makes up. The man who has his master's in civil engineering from UC Berkeley.
Is it blue?
Ball at the back there with the bearded Sean Davies. Debuted against Georgia, Glendale, Colorado, 2012. Scully comes up, knocks it back for his side. And then ball on the ground. It's been kicked through by Phil Mack. And is that flag out? Yes, it is.
So no advantage, the ball is outside. It's not on.
Well, an exciting kick downfield there by the winger in your shot, Kainoa Loy, but the touch flag goes up. We'll see if we can get a replay on this one. Knock on is the call off the American player. Canada just trying to get a sniff inside American territory here. Kainoa Loy, such an impressive winger. Four tries in his 10 caps so far for Canada. As we catch the replay, Sauter going up for this one. Blaine Scully knocks that back beautifully, but Hanko Hammerscheist can't quite get a handle on it, giving back an opportunity to boot it downfield. Ball now here for the Canadians.
I don't have a good picture from you here, okay? I need good gap for him, okay? Give him space. Okay. Thank you.
Good communication there from the Argentine referee, Pablo De Luca.
Let's go.
Canada side.
Let's go, dude. I got you, baby.
Let's go. Good try to open things out. Now they trail by 1 point. We're approaching the 30-minute mark in this first half.
Coach!
We're in Seattle, Washington for this clash.
Bind!
Home of the champion, Seattle Seawolves. They'll play on Sunday here.
Stability.
They'll take on Houston. To the line, McRory. Is that a high shot? Play on, says our referee's Rumble.
Maybe you can check it if you
has
want,
another
please.
Crack himself over the halfway line. Good
release
carry from the loose forward.
Okay.
He started 26 times for his side. We're going
to
have a check here. That looked high from the first angle.
Well, absolutely. Yeah, I think everyone in the ground noticed that one right away. We'll see
just
if we can catch it on the replay. Gordon McRory, the
yellow,
fly half for Canada, stepping off his right foot, going into contact a little awkwardly,
it's
and it did look high. We'll see what referee Pablo De Luca gets from his television match officials. You see McRory stepping, and looks to have been a bit awkward more than anything. I don't think it was malicious by any means.
Okay, so just penalty.
Get a glimpse of it one more time. Going up, riding up towards anything above the shoulders is an automatic penalty with World Rugby's new laws.
Happy with that.
So that'll give a penalty in favor of Canada here.
It goes high. So it will be just, no, it's in the body and it goes high.
So it started low, worked its way up high. Will not be a yellow card, but
it's a good,
penalty in favor of Canada.
We got water inside.
So good call there from referee DeLuca. Any contact, of course, with the head will send you off the field. But that occasion, totally fine.
Again.
For a penalty. But it means that possession gets taken away from the United States. And Canada can drive it downfield with the tackle. Glory's boot. Scored 265 points for his country so far before this game started. Made his debut against Japan in Vancouver, June 2014. And here's another look at a different angle. And that one makes contact with the shoulders at least. Canada into the 22, they march. Blanchett, set there more with Pifferot now at the back.
He threw the middle.
Savetta has come through the middle there. And you heard one of the Canadians saying, where did he come from? John Paul, though, looks to be in an awkward position.
Okay, number six.
And we've got a ping on number six from referee DeLuca. Matt can't get this one out in the U.S. off their feet, so it will
number
be a penalty to Canada.
Number six. Thank you, Danny. No, you were okay. Number
well,
six.
Well, the penalty
swimming.
Against John Quill, right in the thick of it, as you see.
Yeah.
I believe that's Connor Keyes.
Okay.
Getting some medical attention there for Canada. As you see here, Canada setting the drive. Justin Blanchett, Nick Savetta getting right in the middle of it. John Quill on this near side. You can just see him coming in, trying to reach over the top of the Canadian player, Phil Mack, pleading with the referee. Sloppy ball at the back of this driving maul. Nevertheless, Canada now with another line out here deep inside American territory, and Connor Keyes is ready to go.
Well, guys, you heard the call swimming, and what that is a player gets in defense of the maul and then works his way through to get himself into what is an offside position.
Drive for the line. Canada going and they're over. But could this be held up? Referee says, just relax. I'm going to have a look. Canada are very excited. And let's see what referee DeLuca.
Can you hear me? Okay. I want to know on field decision try. I want to know if there's a clear obstruction. For me, the ball carrier is in front, but let me know that, okay? Yeah.
Well, we'll see the replay here. Canada just driving forward. Who's got their hands on it? That looks to be a good try. Hubert Biden's just so much power. Watch the ball at the bottom over the line. Benoit Pifferot smashing this one forward. Two players in support. Who's got their hands on it? That's Luke Campbell, the number eight. Canada scoring their second try of the match. That's Luke Campbell, the man from Victoria, British Columbia, scoring his third try in his ninth cap for Canada. And we're flip-flopping lead here, Dallin. Exciting contest in Seattle.
These matches are always so tight, but that one, perfection off the lineout. And Luke Campbell gets on the board. It's Canada now. Try number two. Conversion attempt from McRory.
Impressed with Canada's forward so far, winning a scrum against the head. Couple of good driving mauls here. Kick goes up from McRory, but the flag stayed down. Scoreline now 12-8 in favor of Canada. Just about 8 minutes to go here in the opening half. Exciting contest.
The United States on their longest win streak over Canada. It started on 25th June 2014. There was one tie in between. Canada looking to right the wrongs of the past. That one taken in from Nick Blevins. started 45 times for his country. McGrory
no,
goes
wait,
down
wait.
The throw.
Six.
Of
Stop. Thank you.
Marcel Brachy, growing up in Cape Town, South Africa, playing with University UCT there in the Tornadoes. His kick, though, taken by Canada, sort of in a good position. Just outside the 22, Mac. Want to keep it in hand, and then finally chip it downfield again.
No,
Mikey
okay,
Teo is
okay.
There in a good position. Teo, the jump step, finds Hanko. Chamisase.
Advantage.
Gets hit high there from Cole Key, so there is advantage here, and none coming.
Tucker.
Well, Cole Keith came in for the cross-cover tackle in support of Andrew Coe, just riding up a little bit on Hammerscheis. He's a big body. It usually takes two players to bring him down. Such a lethal attacking threat here for these Eagles. As you just see the replay here, Coe holding him up. Coe just a little bit high around the neck. No card, just an opportunity for USA to kick downfield now. Under 7 minutes to play in the first half. Canada will need to be smart here, stop this driving maul, which has been so lethal in these last couple of games for the Eagles.
Will McGee gives a message to the back line as the forwards look to take it up.
Advantage.
Landry has an advantage for advantage. The United States.
Yeah, advantage.
And still drive it forward. Tafatee has it at the back.
No,
he scored
one
already tonight and three last weekend. The crowd come alive. Tafatea with that step. Finn, they finally bring him down. Mac was in there. Ben Landry hammering for the line. It's the US. Lasica drives low. Well contained by Ben Lesage. And we're going to come back to the original penalty.
Well, USA's driving maul so lethal once again, getting it in the hands of Taufete.
Early on the maul.
Early on, referee called the advantage right away.
Nah. Yeah, from the 15.
Plenty of time on the clock here until the halftime whistle. USA electing, no surprise here, just finding touch.
Careful with the timing, okay?
Well, Brian, we see this of both teams. Canada opting also to go in for the lineout. It worked out well for them in the first stanza of play. That didn't send over.
Don't cross the gap, red.
Eventually, a good try from Nick Blevins. Luke Campbell got on the board later. It's Tafatee. Goes to the front. It's Landry. They got their maul. And now Tafatee at the back. David Anu'u is with them.
Advantage.
Carrying his teammate forward. Another advantage. Tafatea gets it away. A dummy there from Davies. So the forwards come through and Rumble is in support there with Puffaro. And we're in the danger zone, so let's have a listen.
Captain. We have two penalties in the mall in two minutes, okay?
In the mall.
Yeah, this is the second one.
What
the other one was the early.
What in was the in the mall for?
This one is collapsing, okay? So with your prayers, next one could be a yellow card. Yeah, sure.
Well, no, Captain Rumble wants to have a quick word with his troops. Yeah. That was a clear warning from referee Pablo DeLuca. Next one will be a card.
Yeah.
USA once again just going to kick to touch. USA just driving forward.
Collapsing?
Collapsing is the call.
Yeah, but
they're playing on thin ice here.
Yeah, sure.
Do not want to get a yellow
Captain,
card for a repeat infringement once again.
On the
have to be smart here. Under 4 minutes to play in the first half.
The lineup will take place at the 5 meter mark. Big moment in the game, as you mentioned, halftime approaching. Canada lead 12 points to 8. And the man who has scored 95 points from the US goes high. Taken by Saavedra and then peel around. Chamisase. Goes around the fringes. Desperate times here for the Eagles. Quill. And now it's Landry. Urgency from the United States. Paul Lasica, the 28-year-old, born in Auckland, New Zealand. Dolan. He's tall, can't reach for the line this occasion. Chamisase gets through the first two. Wow! Hanko Chamisase. Puts down
no hands, Fred.
Blevins, And here it is, a wide ball, Brachy. Brachy just short.
Now Hansred.
Davies wants to dig this one out. They score it. Cam Dolan has touched us down. Try number 15 in his 44th appearance. And Cam Dolan puts the US ahead just before the half.
Well, you could sense it was coming. USA continued pressure deep inside Canada's territory. Hanko Hammerscheis with a massive, massive bump on Ben Lesage here. We're going to go back to the original start to this play. Ball cleaned up at the top there by Nick Savetta. Going blind is Hammerscheis once again, brought down by Benoit Piffarot, as we see once again. Look at the play here by Hammerscheis. Lesage trying to hold him up.
David, are you talking
upended. Pretty awkward tackle there. USA still getting the go-forward ball there.
Sure.
And it's the veteran number 8, Cam Dolan, scoring his 15th try for the Eagles to retake the lead.
Dolan, the avid golfer, started 33 times for the U.S. over the years. He was with the San Diego Legion for a while, Northampton Saints, Cardiff Blues. Now he finds himself at NOLA Gold. They're doing superbly in Major League Rugby Season 2. Conversion attempt. Nicely done from Will McGee. And that stretches the legs for the United States. They're up 15 points to 12 against Canada. The flags are flying high.
Too many penalties for this Canadian side. You've already heard the warning once from referee Pablo DeLuca. Gordon McRory will need to get his side deep back inside the USA territory. Try to look for a penalty or possibly a try here. Under 1 minute to play.
Hammerscheis takes this one. Davies just wants to slow things down with his side. Tafate'e needs to be solid with this and gets tackled by Lloyd. Davies shapes up for a box kick. Puts this one down just past the halfway line. Bounces up and Sorda takes it with the attention from Scully. The visiting side will take position just before the half.
Now Hans Blue.
The forward pods set up the middle. They look to go with Bidens, longest serving member of the squad, 13 years. And then McRory says, I want to go and get some oranges at halftime. It's two tries apiece. And it's the United States, though, that lead. Canada here at the break. And Joe Tafate'e scored with Cam Dolan. Blevins and Campbell have scored for the Canadian side. Just 3 points separating these two sides. A very interesting second half awaits us.
Well, excitement from both sides here at Starfire Sports Stadium. Giving the fans their money's worth.
USA Rugby's on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, and YouTube. Back from USA Rugby on social media to find game scores, Eagles news, and the latest updates on rugby in America. Tweet out live action from our game tonight using the hashtag Eagles United and follow at USA Rugby to get more information on rugby in the United States. Merchandise, we got it. Don't forget, stop by merchandise 10 outside the main gate tonight. Give your rugby an event year. And some support our local Washington Youth rugby team members. See tickets for tonight's 50-50 raffle.
take home 50% of all ticket sales. So talk. And you all know this, this year's HSBC Canada Women's Sevens returning to Lindford, British Columbia on May 11th and 12th. Tickets are on sale beginning in mid-March. Visit CanadaSevens.com for more information. Rugby Canada thanks their Men's 15's primary partners, the AHL, Canterbury, and Kubota. There's more enhances Rugby Canada's program and the experience of all of our Men's 15 players.
It's the RFC defending champions, the USA Eagles, that have a halftime lead of 15-12 over Canada in the North American rivalry. Four tries scored in the first 40 minutes here in Seattle, Washington. And it started off with a penalty by Will McGee, and then Canada getting on the board next.
Well, over 15 phases deep inside enemy territory, Canada is rewarded. The veteran Phil Mack doing a triple miss pass to Nick Blevins, smashing his way over the line. Getting his side into this one.
The U.S. responded straight afterwards. The maul, the drive, and of course, it's big Joe Tafate'e that has it at the back. He peels away and gets try number 19, and the Eagles back in the game.
Canada would respond, though. That's Justin Blanchett taking this one, setting the drive. Luke Campbell, he's got his hands on it. USA on roller skates, can't stop him. Second try for the Canadians.
United States, though, just before the halftime break, they go wide. Brachy just short. And then clever thinking from Cam Dolan, the number eight. This will be one of the easier tries he gets. He pointed to the line and said, I'm going to go and score this try right there, and did just that. And his 44th cap for the US Eagles. And so we're going to step aside for another break. And when we return, we'll hear from both head coaches. At the halftime break, it's the USA 15, Canada 12 from Starfire Sports Stadium in Seattle, Washington. The United States, ranked 13 in the world, are up 15-12 against number 21, Canada, in their final America's Rugby Championship fixture of 2019 here at Starfire Sports Stadium in Seattle, Washington. Yesterday, we spoke with Canadian head coach Kingsley Jones about this year's ARC competition.
Yeah, this year's tournament has been good and bad for us. I think we've shown a lot of endeavour and commitment in the tournament, but the challenges of travelling down to South America with short preparation in terms of, you know, 30 hours to get there, I think that's a challenge for the competition, but that's a good test for the players as well, as how they respond to that. We should have won early on in Uruguay, which would have given us confidence. I felt a little bit hard done by that day, losing the final play of the game. Tough one to take, but again, learning. But, you know, we've returned to Canada for a couple of games. Chile was obviously to nil someone was an excellent experience for the players. And then, of course, moving into Argentina last week again, I thought it was a really good performance against a very good side. And we got to build on that, those two performances, into this tough game here in Seattle against the USA. We know USA will be extra motivated, having been defeated last week by Uruguay. But they don't need any extra motivation to play against Canada, of course. So it's a big challenge. Both sets of players look forward to that. But yeah, I think if we can build on the last two games and see games out, we have a chance of course getting a good win tomorrow. But as I said, we know how good the USA are. They'll be disappointed with some of their ARC. So they'll want to finish on a high. So looking forward to a tough test.
And USA Eagles head coach Gary Gold, well, he shared his thoughts about the tough competition following their captain's run on Friday.
Oh, and the mood in the camp is good. It's disappointing, you know, that we, you know, didn't put ourselves in a position to win this competition and obviously, you know, haven't now won it, now that Argentina have won it. So there's a little bit of disappointment around that. But as I say, you know, these are the lessons that I think we needed to learn. You know, I think things were going particularly well for a long period of time and you know, for whatever the reasons are, and you know, I'll take full responsibility for it. You know, there's certain things that, you know, maybe if it wasn't complacent, we didn't execute as well as we have done in the past, and we pay the price for that. You know, and coupled with the fact that other teams are improving as well, and have obviously targeted us as you know, last year's champions. So, I think the mood in the camp is really good. Canada USA is always on its own as a spectacle. It's a great rivalry, and you know, we really want to finish this competition on a good note.
It's the USA that lead Canada by 3 points after 40 minutes. Which way will this one fall? We'll find out soon. Up next, second half action from Starfire Sports Stadium in Seattle, Washington. Hello and a warm welcome to you for round five action in the 2019 America's Rugby Championship. It's the United States, the home team in blue, that lead Canada by slender 3 points. 15-12 the score, 2 tries apiece. And we're at the home of the Seattle Seawolves, Starfire Sports Stadium, for this clash. I'm Dallas Stafford, joined in the booth by Canadian star Brian Kelly.
Well, it's been an exciting first 40 minutes here, and I think that's exactly what we're going to get in the final 40 minutes. Both these sides looking to impress with all eyes on the Rugby World Cup 2019 selection, as you get a quick glimpse of Canada's reserves. Good. Patrick Parfrey started the first 3 matches at fly half for Canada, and a potential debut for Jordan Olsen.
And the United States, a couple of stars on their bench as well. Let's see how we go. Second half underway. Canada in red receive this. They trail by 3.
Stay there.
Early downfield kick from Gordon McRory, and Marcel Brachy is there. Scored a great try against Russia last season. Still ball in hand. Dummy thrown there from McGee. That unfortunate, in fact, Connor Keyes shuts him down. There's a player down on the ground, and Captain Rumble as Anu'u takes a fine line off Tafate'e. Now the forwards combined with Landry, and the back line's Brachy. Marcel Brachy into the line. Great play from the fullback. Inside the 22, Landry can't get through a double tackle. Ball comes through to Mullen. Mikey Tao looking for work. The US want to start the second half better than it did the first.
Leon,
that's right, knocked back from Quill. So Davies goes to clean things up. He gets hit hard. So lost territory, but still keep possession.
Yes, it.
Tao in at 9. Slow ball, so they try to set something up. Landry loops around, another tidal wave of tackles come in. McGee spots a little gap himself. It was a good line by Bryce Campbell a bit earlier as Dolan takes it against the grain. Now John Quill. Quill's team, the Rugby United New York side, hosting their first home game ever, professional rugby, next Friday. Make sure to check that out.
No problem.
McGee still works. Dolan yet again looking for work. Scored one in the first half. Canada strong so far on defense. Ball comes up here at the top. Mullen again. Campbell spits free from McRory's tackle. They work hard to recycle. It's Brachy. He's the one that had that good break initially. Man born in Los Angeles but grew up in South Africa. Davies sniping around to the captain. Blaine Scully, Superman Scully.
Release!
Gets through the first tackle. It was Phil Mack. And now Tafate'e.
Okay.
Three
offside
players
red
in his channel. There's an offside play. Advantage for the United States.
You.
Campbell goes wide, throws a dummy. Tao Quinn, hands! Dolan just short. And that one's been dropped. Referee says, play on. It stays with the Eagles. Tense stuff here for the visiting side, the Canadians. Big dummy from John Quill. David Anu'u is there, 19 years and 108 days. Man plays rugby in Toulouse in France on his fourth appearance tonight. Tao Loops in the middle, looking for work. The left winger. Landry yet again. He'll run all night. Spilt three. So Dolan tries to get this one out.
Offside,
and Luka has his arm up.
Number five.
And ping there is Kyle Bailey.
Well, USA upping their physicality to start this game. Canada on the wrong side of a couple of massive collisions here in the opening 3 minutes of the second half.
Excuse me?
Giving USA an opportunity now. You see a couple of bodies, hands on knees, a couple of Canadian players not able to get up right away. This could be a long second half here for Canada.
Wait.
Flanker Justin Blanchett took a really awkward hit from a massive collision.
Captain, remember what we talked about the most?
Seeing some medical attention. Wouldn't be surprised to see him taking a break here as we see the USA spinning this ball sideline to sideline. This ball getting in the hands of Teo and then Dolan.
Yeah.
Alex, what you got for us on the sideline?
Well, guys, talk to Coach Greg McWilliams from the USA, the attack coach, and he likened the team to an orchestra, 15 of the same instrument playing at the same time. He said right now they've got a couple of those instruments are a little bit out of tune, and they're just tweaking things, and that's sort of
the big difference
for them. Meanwhile, on the Canadian side, the message we're getting from the bench, they're a little unhappy with their defensive alignment. Too many players flooding one side or the other and not looking up to see where the USA is and where the ball's going. So the USA, on the other hand, trying to attack wide.
Is
Canada
he going out?
Having trouble tracking them. Back to you guys.
Captain.
Well, look to be a substitution here for Canada. Justin Blanchett.
Yeah, he's coming.
Looks to be doing an HIA assessment. Dustin Dabrowski coming on the field now, getting a glimpse of Starfire Sports Stadium, opened in 2005, home of the 2018 MLR champions, Seattle Seawolves.
Time back on.
Passionate rugby following here in the Pacific Northwest, cheering this American side on in the second half.
Moral set, Tafatea has it at the back yet again. Landry telling his charges to move back in field, the touchline looms.
Stop once. He's okay.
And here they go.
It's okay.
Close to the line yet again. It's the forward Mike from the USA looking to push them over. It's another try. Number three, the United States against Canada. And who's getting up for the ball this time? It's applause for Joe Tafatea. He could have tried number 20, chasing Richie McCall's all-time record of 27. You legend.
This home crowd absolutely loving it here at Starfire Sports Stadium. That's five tries in two games, and we still have plenty to play here. USA once again just using their attacking threat, the driving maul. Canada trying to recycle. Plenty of bodies dogpiling in that right corner. And Taufete with his hands on it. Plenty of support there. Even Blaine Scully, the captain for USA, getting in on it. USA just dominant to open this second half. And that man right there, Joe Taufete, making it look easy. Another USA score.
And that's his 100th point for the United States. The man who played football at Santa Ana College. Switched to rugby when he got to Long Beach at Belmont Shore. Conversion from McGee stays to the left-hand side. But it extends the lead 20 points to 12 right now in the second half for the United States.
Canada needs to rally here. That was a slow start to that second half. Dabrowski on the field now for Justin Blanchett.
Sure.
Need to rally here. Need to stay in this game. The next points need to be from a Canadian jersey if they want to get back in this game.
Chamisais receives this one. Formerly with the Austin Elite. Back to the Glendale Raptors in his professional contract. Known as the Terminator. The CK puts it on the left boot. Chipped up to McGrory, who goes to Sorda. Sorda with the Toronto Arrows. Nice cap for him. Made his debut against Scotland and Edmonton. And then penalty for Canada.
He's tackled because the knee's on the floor.
Theo Sauter, such a shifty runner. Tackled. Slippery in the midfield. Beating one tackler. Had his knees on the ground. Therefore, the tackle is completed. Player must release him. Now an opportunity for Canada. Slow things down. Deep clearance kick here from McLaurie. Gets Canada inside the 22. Looking to get their ball into the hands of Sauder, Coe, and Lloyd as much as possible, as we see here, stepping once, cutting right through. Quill has to release that ball, just holding on to him and then trying to rip it back to his side. Opportunity now for the Canadians.
Befara goes to the front. Good take from Canada. But the US has stopped this one.
Last team.
Canada are lucky to get that ball. Because Connor Keyes grabbing it a bit awkwardly. Quill was right in the inside. Tried to poach it, but referee Pablo DeLuca is going to reset this and give a ball back to Canada. As we see on the replay here, Piffero stolen there originally. Connor Keyes trying to get it back. Canada need to maintain possession if they want to stay in this game, taking advantage of all their opportunities here. Ball now in the hands of their leader, Phil Mack.
Bind! Set!
Mack looking to feed this rivalry that dates back to 1977, and this scrum will just reset.
No, no, we don't have stability. We need stability first. We need stability first. I will change side.
No, big shove there from the Americans, trying to assert their physical dominance here as we catch a replay of it. Watch the engine room of USA just driving forward. Bit early is the call. Phil Mack telling his front rowers to dig. Really get low here.
Coach!
The last time Canada defeated the US was in August 2013.
Mind!
The Rugby World Cup 2015 qualified 13-11. They won at BMO Field in Toronto. And that day, two Canadians, Phil Mack and Nick Blevins, featured. Mack now in possession, goes the other way. Good ball to Blevins, the two players we just spoke about. As they peel around the fringes, Canada inside the 22.
Release that clue! Thank you.
Piffero, first receiver, gets it away. Cole Keith in support. 21 years of age, debut against Chile at Langford in 2017. Captain Rumble ducks down into this one. We're going to go wide with McGrory and Blevins now with a step. Finally brought down by Bryce Campbell. It's quick ball, little gap there for Phil Mack. Look at a sniper around the fringes. Canada inch their way closer. 8 points the difference so far. 10 minutes gone in the second half. Connor Keyes in there. Man who plays with the Rotherham Titans. Bidens arrives. Looking for another score. The ball still available. Good hands. Behind the back ball. Sorda. Can't get through. Quill brings him down. Canada scored two in the first half. Rumble. This is how they sent Nick Blevins away. It was a wide ball from scrum half Phil Mack. Always looking up, seeing his options. He lets Bidens take this one. The US defenders holding strong so far. Quill
release.
Looks to try to get this one. They keep it tight. In they go with Cole Keith. Helping out there is Dustin Dabrowski. Now wide they go. It's a short ball. Well handled by the US defense. As Canada condensed the attack. And that man, Lucas Rumble, has been everywhere tonight. Such an active player. Mack on a short line. Long passage of play. Then a bump and the get off man. Look, don't argue. Unbelievable power and strength to bust through. And it's Canada that have try number three. And it's scored by Luke Campbell. He has a double.
We'll take a bow, Luke Campbell, the man from the James Bay Athletic Association. Rightfully so, hands on knees. That was a fantastic passage of play there for the Canadians. Phil Mack just the general marshaling his troops around the pitch here. Watch the line that Luke Campbell comes in on, smashing two Eagles out of the way for his second try of the match. Inspirational stuff here from the Canadians, trailing by 8 points. Cam Dolan on the wrong side of that, as you see Campbell taking a bit of a knock there, right on the nose.
Good, good.
And we've got an exciting passage of play here once again, both these sides back and forth.
Pitch here from Alex on the pitch side.
Well, guys, Campbell may have scored that try, but at the heart of all of that was Phil Mack, the spark plug scrum half for Canada. And when his name was mentioned at the beginning of the game, introducing the players to the crowd, a huge cheer goes up because, of course, he's also at the heart of the Seattle Seawolves fandom here. He was the one who led that team to a Major League Rugby championship, and he is highly respected here. But Phil Mack has been an Eagle killer for over a decade here for Canada, one of the fittest players on the team, and he was in the middle of every single action that led to that try. Back to you guys.
Yeah, and just blood there for Luke Campbell. He will be replaced just for a few moments.
Stepping on the field now for his 12th cap is Josh Larson, the man who plays for Austin Elite in MLR. A blood sub opportunity on the field for Campbell, the try scorer, who connected with Dolan.
He's out. Just relax. Yeah, you can't.
USA, the excellent tackle right on this near touchline. Yeah. That's Mikey Tao on Andrew Coe, holding his right arm there.
Red.
As USA gets set once again, ball in the hands of their danger man.
At the 22, yes. Tuffer 2019 the score.
Turn number two, keep bind.
They have it at the back, then Maul drives forward yet again.
Keep bind.
It's an area that Sean Pittman, former Eagle, 30 caps and a Rugby World Cup under his belt. He's based here in Seattle. They break away though. Lasique gets it away to his centre partner, Campbell.
Release!
Bryce Campbell, the man with London Irish in England. As the forwards peel around now with Saavedra. Played rugby in Italy for three seasons. Also in New York, big strong carry. Another one from Ben Landry. Been so good tonight as Landry. Tao flicks it away. Brachy fires it in. 6 meters out. Quill has to reach to collect this. The US full lineup to the side. Tafatea. Lasique, they spot him. But the center has the leg drive to keep going. Tao, we just saw him on the other side of the wing. Now tackled by Dobrowski in 20. Tafatea. Well handled. Ryan Kudlowski. In fact, there's Josh Larson. Landry through the back. They go. Brachy gets it wide to Campbell. The crowd on the edge of their seats. 55 minutes gone in this clash. It's David Anu'u from Olympia, Washington. Paul Lasique.
Release!
They bring it down. Ben Lesage does well. They've turned it around.
No call.
Wonderful work from Canada under all sorts of pressure. And that one came with Blaine Scully.
Excellent stuff there from Ben Lesage, ripping that ball out of his hands. Bit of a misconnection there. Deep inside Canadian territory, Theo Sauter does well to just find touch. I believe that was off an American hand, so it will be a Canadian ball. They get lucky there, deep inside their own half. Catching the replay here. Into contact is Lasique. Cole Keith goes low. Support from Benoit Piffero, but it's ripped there by the youngster Lesage. Hubert Biden does well to find Bailey, who finds Sauter. Great rip there from the young man from the UBC Thunderbirds.
Captain,
he was in
Captain
class
we need
earlier
to play.
This week.
We can't stop. Yeah. We
what
need
a,
to
what
play.
A big moment for him, Brian.
No,
on
we
the
can't.
Field right now. Late
it's,
withdrawal
it's,
from
it's,
Kieran
it's
Hearn.
Not part of the line.
Can't start?
No. Yeah, we can. No, we can.
We trying to play up tempo, Pablo. We trying to play up tempo.
Time up on.
Every stop is they trying to slow it down.
Yeah, I agree.
So everybody seems to be okay, back on their feet.
Thank you.
Quick power pack there from Ben Lesage. A little bit of burst of energy. He's having a great game so far. First game back since the Brazil match down in Sao Paulo. Second round of the America's Rugby Championship.
Lost on the target at the back. Canada inside their 22. Dobrowski, 27 years old, debuted against the United
States. He's onside.
Last year. This one comes down to Blaine Scully. Superman Scully goes across field.
Tackle!
Famous rugby program there underneath Jack Clark. Teo, quick ball. The CK, they came up on him. Campbell was looping around his center partner. Quill at first receiver. Throws the dummy as the number six. He debuted 7 years ago against Tonga. Teo gets away to Kamasase. Kamasase always knocking players to the ground. Just 1 point in this clash. You might expect that going into this with the form of the United States the last couple of years. Dipped a bit in this ARC competition as Brahe goes over the top. Blaine Scully skips through a couple. Golan is in support. Brahe again. The US put the faces together, put themselves in some half gaps. Campbell, tough at air, hit hard. It's gone back, so Teo steps up the middle. Former Sevens international star. McGee goes wide again. Landry, energy sapping stuff for Canada to defend us. Tafatea yet again. What a work rate he has. Almost 60 minutes gone. The CK fires
no
one
five.
In. Steel tackles advantage coming in from the middle ring. It's now advantage right underneath the sticks. Kamasase. And then Rookie yet again. Great bit of defense there from Lesage, but let's see what DeLuca has for us.
Captain, you had too many penalties here. Last time was for more, now it's for penalties, okay? Talk with your team. Yeah. No, we can't.
Another stern talking to from the referee. That's Lucas Rumble. Had one earlier in the first half.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Potentially be reaching to his pocket. Ready, Captain? Send it down now to Alex. What do you have for us on the sideline?
Well, guys, we've got a couple of substitutions coming on. Ruben de Haas is just set to come on for the USA at scrum half. We did see Sean Davies limping around in the first half. He got stepped on, I think. But I think this is more of a tactical sub. He's a very quick passer. They're looking to exploit Canada wide. And I think that's why we are going to see de Haas coming on right now for the USA. Back to you guys.
Ruben de Haas, good picture of the youngster on the side. Meanwhile, it's a penalty attempt for Will McGee out of University of Leeds and the Erling Trail Finders. He turns quickly yet again. It's 23-19 US lead approaching the 60-minute mark against Canada.
And it makes it USA 23, Canada 19.
Lasique smashing this ball forward. Sloppy breakdown here, not rolling away. There is Kyle Bailey.
Right.
Another big run there from Hammerscheis. Luke Campbell back on the pitch now after a blood sub. Two
time
tries for that man. Fresh on the pitch now. Malon Aljabouri. Seven star as well. Former captain of the under 20 team for USA. Made his debut against Chile in 2018.
Canada.
Good.
Put it to the 22. Chasers are there. And a drop coming in there from Nick Savetta. It'll give possession to the visiting side.
Knock on.
Well, at least half a dozen or so times in this game so far in the 60 minutes. Both these teams just seem to be gifting it back and forth. As soon as one team scores, they give it right back to the opposing team. This seems to be a easy play right off the kickoff. He had a jump, but can't quite hold on to the pill. Now, opportunity here for Canada, trailing only by 4 points. Just over 20 minutes to play here. Great attacking platform.
A lot of tired bodies out there. This has been a ferocious
coach!
One. We always knew it's going to be close. Phil Mack, the veteran Mine! Leading things for the Canadian side. Born in Victoria.
Set! Wait.
Debut in 2009. Ball comes up. now for Andrew Coe. Rumble, the captain, loops around. They stop him. Quill needs to roll away.
So yeah, advantage.
Conversate. Are you serious? Yes, we are serious.
Mutin.
Canada told to use it. They need something big here to put themselves up by one. Turns it back on the inside to Puffaro. Roke has been very active tonight. Good quick hands there from Cole Keith. Into open space. Blevins looping around. McRory, good switch.
Still playing advantage red.
Well handled. El Jabouri comes in and makes a tackle.
Yep.
Still advantage here for Canada. Rumble. Rumble! Been everywhere as Piffero goes. Rumble's hurt in back play. East side, still pick and drive. Here they go through Sorda. Gets it over the top, nice ball. That switch just picked up there.
It's a knock on.
Lloyd has it, no advantage there. We'll go back to the penalty.
Well, that was a long advantage there by Pablo De Luca.
Yeah,
not rolling away is the call.
I'm sorry, I think it was accidental. If we have any punch, just let me know, okay?
Captain Rumble calling for an infraction from an American player unsuccessfully. Another strong set of phases there from the Canadians. Rumble pointing to the sticks here. As we take a look at the penalty here, Benoit Piffero breaking the gain line. Malin Aljabouri just slowly rolling away from that one. Pardon me, that's Tafutei. Players all over this ball, not giving Canada an opportunity to really recycle this ball quickly.
I didn't saw that.
Ben Lesage trying to find Kainoa Lloyd. And now Gordon McRory. Fourth all-time in the point scored list for Canada. Looking to bring this game within 1 point.
From in front, McRory. He likes it. It's 23-22 the score. And let's see what is happening on the bench there, Alex Goff.
All right, guys, we've got a few more subs coming on. Olive Khalifi, the local guy, coming on for the other local boy, David Ainu'u. And Nick Savetta is coming off, and Greg Peterson, who's been in great form, coming on at second row for the USA. Phil Mack comes off for Canada with Jamie McKenzie coming on, and Cam Dolan is off right now for a head injury assessment. Malin Aljabouri coming on for him. Maybe temporary, maybe permanent. We'll see later.
Massive tackle coming there from Tafutei, and we're going to have a look at that one as well. It's a high hit on Blevins. And no, perhaps just falling down was Blevins there. Looked pretty solid because, of course, Tafutei is almost 300 pounds.
Tafutei, a big unit here. Nick Blevins stopping, cutting back, going into contact. Well, right away, referee Pablo De Luca saying that was not a card, but an interesting call, could be debated, but that's the reality here. Another penalty in favor of Canada. Jamie McKenzie on the pitch now at scrum half.
Will your team with you?
Be a strong connection with Gordon McRory. McKenzie has started all four of the previous America's Rugby Championship matches so far in this campaign.
Puffaro to feed the line out.
Blue, don't close the gap.
Short on numbers. They've got plenty now in the back line to attack with. Canada just getting set. In comes Luke Campbell.
He's on side.
Great
He's
charge already. Box kick.
Advantage
been
knock on.
Dropped there by Coe. Advantage there is De Haas on the field. Beautiful
advantage
spiral
over.
Kick. Advantage is now over. Still being caught. Sorda puts one over the top. McGee's there inside the 22. Down to McRory. Awkward bounce. The fly-off regathers. It goes to Brachy. Marcel Brachy beats the first. Goes up the middle. fullback gets the US back on the front foot. De Haas to McGee. There's a lot of space there. Inside the Canadian 22. Sorda leaves this one. It's still available. Okay, ball hasn't gone out. Now it has.
Knock on. Good. Knock on, Red.
Referee calling a knock on against Canada. Then it was knocked on by USA. We'll see if we can get a replay of exactly what happened here. USA noticing that there was nobody back on this near touchline. Here's Campbell chasing it. He can't get a handle on it. This one bounces awkwardly. That's where the knock on comes off the hands of Campbell.
Red flag, flag, goal. Second.
Driven into touch there by Jamie McKenzie. Under 15 minutes to go here. USA deep inside Canadian territory now. With that narrow one-point advantage.
Look for big Paul Lasica. Inside center, former Chicago Bear in the NFL.
Now, two, three.
Played rugby as well with the Utah Warriors.
Ball not hooked, the ball must be hooked. No, it wasn't.
Well, a free kick is awarded to Canada.
The ball was not hooked.
We'll see if we can get a glimpse on this near side. Ball not hooked there by Taufete.
5 meters.
We'll see if this big play comes back to haunt the USA. McRory keeps this one in.
It's play on. The United States have Brachy. The fullback puts it down into the 22 to his opposite number. Field Sorda. Just chips this one to Brachy yet again. It's aerial ping pong, but now Brachy has a crack himself. Marcel Brachy. He's captain the US on a couple of occasions. And here they go. On is Olive Khalifi, the local man, the Seattle Seawolf. Peterson on the field as well, wearing 19. Plenty of fresh legs for both these teams. Khamisais. Oh, big Hanko Khamisais. Bumps a couple. The raging bull. That'll light up the home fans. Khalifi yet again, 32 years young. Behind the back, Lasique goes wide. Quill is there with Brachy. Soft hands, Teo flicks it up again to Lasique. He gets through the another tackle. The US enjoying themselves. Taufete dishes that one off. De Haas, quick service from the replacement nine. Khalifi yet again. He gets another roar from the crowd. This one has been intercepted. And Khamisais drives back Lloyd.
Release Lou!
It's inside the 22. Canada can breathe yet again.
You shoot!
A box kick or something downfield. They set their forwards up. Involved there was Connor Keys. Now they look for McRory's boots. This one towards the touchline. It's been kept in by McGee. Now Mike Teo. Mikey Teo.
Release runs
right. Straight into a park car. To the left they go. Lasique, good hands. Campbell can get rid of the first player. Sorda does well. Tougher to air. Yet again into the 22. Rumbles with him. De Haas. This one is off the boot. It's Canada. They have possession. McRory, a wall of blue jerseys in front of him. He turns it into Lloyd. The winger does well to break the advantage line. The visiting side, they keep it in hand. Still 1 point in it. 10 to go. Sorda, they've knocked that one on. A long passage of play, but many exciting moments in
just
that one.
Just knock on, yeah.
Well, I'm starting to worry just about your voice me. There, Dell, and that's an exciting string of phases here. Both sides going sideline to sideline here, hands on knees. This is an extensive work rate from both these sides. As you see the knock on here, Lesage can't find fellow Thunderbird teammate Ko. We talk about the work rate of both these teams just flying into contact. Absolute passionate stuff here. USA's bench, Aljaburi, Peterson, and Khalifi just making a huge impact fresh on the pitch here.
drive. Got it.
Well, let's switch across to Rugby World Cup. And Canada find themselves in Pool B. They've got the All Blacks. They've got the Springboks. But they take on Italy and Namibia as well. They've got a fair their chances in those clashes as well.
Very realistic for Canada. Captain. A goal ahead to Captain. Finish 2-2 at the Rugby row. World Cup. So starting off against Italy, okay. Ending against yeah. Namibia, and then two fantastic contests in the middle against Ready? The All Blacks and Good. South Africa.
But you missed the hook. You missed
we'll come
the
back
hook.
To the United States Pool C.
I saw that you used your foot. You I'll move it, and you missed the hook.
Of course, the qualifiers, well, the U.S. drew to Canada 28-4
at
Tim Hortons Field in Hamilton, Ontario, and then won the return fixture in San Diego 52-16 at Torero Stadium.
We need one, let's go!
Don't forget, folks, this is the fifth round of the America's Rugby Championship. There was a break
Coach!
In between the South American leg and back up into North America, but a lot of these players had to return and play Major League Rugby. So this is, for some of these bodies, this is the sixth game, high-quality game in six consecutive weekends, and that's tough on anybody here, as you can see. And now it's a war of attrition here with less than 10 minutes to play.
Taken in there by inside center, Lasica. And Aljaburi. The US looping around with their big units. Khalifi again. Monsters through. Rumble just barely brings him down. Onto the front foot they go yet again. Teo bringing the heat. Inside the 22. Canada do well though. Sorda comes in as well. And Lesage yeah, okay. is there. Stolen. The backs do well. Ball sits with Jamie McKenzie, plays for the Toronto Arrows. Younger brother Phil McKenzie, not out yet again. A lot of Canada's kicks have stayed in the field to play, giving players like Teo an opportunity. Lasique looms large. Quick ball, they go, and it's Khamisace as well. This time they bring him to the ground. Aljaburi gets missed on that occasion as Landry. Sets up another ruck. Shielding their players accidentally. Tafate'e just got the timing wrong with that one.
Well, that's a clear obstruction in midfield now. What does Canada do? Just over 8 minutes to go, and absolutely no question, pointing for the sticks. That's Rumble. Canada has been absolutely throwing their bodies into the breakdown here. And USA is continuously smashed forward. And this is a gift. We've seen McRory kick plenty of points in his career for Canada. Started this game with 265 points. This could give Canada only their second lead of this game. We're going to send it down now to Alex.
Well, guys, we've got another substitution getting ready to come on after this kick is attempted with Capelli Pifoletti, the hooker, coming on probably for Joe Taufete. Young hooker who was in the Saracens program in the UK. And it's going to be an interesting change to get fresh legs on the number two jersey. Back to you guys.
This one now, for the lead.
Now, 30 minutes.
McGrory has kicked one already tonight.
So that is not okay, okay? Okay, let me know.
Just short of the halfway line. The biggest kick yet attempted in this game. And it is successful. The flags finally go up. It took them an eternity to be raised, but it's Canada 25, US 23.
Well, it doesn't matter how far it gets over the bar, as long as it gets over the bar. That's Gordon McRory giving a 2-point lead here, under 7 minutes to play. Oh, this is going to come right down to the final whistle. You can tell both these sides wanting to end their ARC campaign off with a strong win.
Into the 22. Canada receive this.
No, it's okay.
So many of these clashes
have
been within 7 points over the years. Match number 61 between these sides tonight. Brachy has another opportunity to counterattack. The defenders rise up a bit high on him. Another big carry this time. It's Capelli Pifoletti, his second cap, the man from the San Diego Legion. Major League Rugby side, Lasique. Bryce Campbell, tackled by his opposite number, Lesage. will yet again. Peterson, formerly with the Leicester Tigers and Glasgow Warriors. Brophy. Yes, he can flew in with that one. As Peterson takes it in again. Time for the US to see if they can breach the strong Canadian defense. Big tackle there from Bobrovsky as well. It's McGee. Campbell, Bryce Campbell. Another titanic collision. Pifoletti hit hard. Here it goes again. Pifoletti! How did he get free? David Copperfield takes some notes. McGee tries to get to the half gap.
Bad, red.
It's the captain that got involved. Turnover for Rumble.
Yeah, get on my right.
The men in red.
You see it?
Concede a line break, but turn things around. Under five to go. McRory. In fact, it's McKenzie. And his 17th appearance puts it down to Brachy. Still not out. Teo, there's width here. Space for Superman Scully. They hit him hard. Very impressive. Ben Lesage. Now Lasique looking for extra work. The inside center.
No red!
Pifaro try to pinch that. The US stretch the field. Chamises. Love seeing him lurking in the wing position as Aljibrouri takes contact yet again. Campbell.
Yeah, high tackle.
They go high, this time pinged. It's kickable. So McGee just has a free play downfield. They're going to come back to the penalty.
High tackle from number five. Good. Caps hand.
Fucking everyone get deeper.
We talked about this before. He's need too many penalties in the second half. I can't. No,
what's
I can't.
The call for? I don't even know what
it's
call
a high tackle.
But they're on three or four.
It's a high tackle. Zero call for you.
They're on three or four.
It's not because of the high tackle. It's because you're many penalties in the second. Okay.
Well, a big blow to this Canadian side. Up by 2 points. Under 4 minutes to play.
Water.
Yellow card water, handed to Kyle Bailey.
We need to play.
Both teams guilty of a couple of high tackles late in this game. Although Canada has been given two warnings, this kick certainly within range, just over the 40-meter line now.
Did you check the mark, Danny?
Huge moment in this game.
They are selling me 5 meters back.
They'll play with 14 for the rest of the game.
Are you going to keep to huge? Shot, or you want to play? Because
yeah, I can shoot.
Good.
McGee says I can shoot that. Well, let's hope he does if you're supporting the USA, and if you're a Canadian fan, let's see how confident the number 10 is.
I will say, Dallin, that if you're a Eagles supporter or a Canadian fan, no matter what, you have to be pleased with the level of intensity in the last 10 minutes of this test match. Both teams are playing like it's the Rugby World Cup final.
So here we go, the big kick of the game. The crowd... They thought it went over, just to the side it stays. 25-23, Canada lead. Under 3 minutes to go.
Time off, substitution. Two. Substitution. I'm going to ask the desk.
Alex, what do you got for us there?
John, let me know the time, please.
Well, guys, you got a couple more subs on. Dino Waldron comes on as prop for the USA.
Yes, substitution.
And
who is going
Tad
out?
Leaders come on as the new fly half.
Substitution, nobody?
For Will McGee, who just missed that kick. And that kick, guys, that missed by just this much. Real close.
It was. Tight leader on the field. Big shoes to fill. The 28-year-old from Galway in Ireland. It's a 22-minute dropout. Canada on the verge of causing a huge upset. 21 in the world. Leader, first touch for him. Teo thought about putting the kick over the top, but then Mikey Teo in open space. Mikey Teo busts around the fringes. Still going. The winger has put the US back inside the 22. And now Quill. Landry with a crowd behind him. Blue jerseys everywhere. Khalifi, the hometown. Time leader goes to the line himself. It's within 3 meters. Now they're on the line. We're going to have to check. Referee thinks it's held up.
Ball felt up.
It is. Scrum. It'll be scrum to the United
Ball
States.
Ball felt up.
With scrum. About a minute to go.
Well, take a bow, Mikey Tao, just electrifying this home audience, slicing 60 meters upfield, getting his side back
it's
in the driver's
okay.
seat. Here. Just about 1 minute to play. All the time you spend in the gym, all the time you spend on the training field comes down to this moment right here, this last set piece, what could be the final play of the game for these two sides. Look at the steam coming off these bodies.
Well, Canada lost to Brazil 18-10. They lost to Uruguay 2017. They just beat Chile, their only victory, and they lost to the Argentina 15. This will be massive for their program, as we said. They'll take a break for a few months before Rugby World Cup 2019. And it's
Coach!
The United States with De Haas.
Mind!
USA chants reverberate around
Set!
Starfire Sports Stadium here in Seattle, Washington. The ball at the back with John Quill.
Advantage.
They're
you
going
did.
For the line. They've got advantage. De Haas picks up and dummies. He goes over. What a dive. Has he dived too far? America, the brave.
John, can you hear me? John, yeah? Is it okay? Okay, so it's the it will finish after the kick, yeah.
Absolute scenes here in Seattle. Canada's scrum going backwards. Here's De Haas, the replacement scrum half, and he almost dives too far.
Yeah, so it's the last ball.
But what a play there from the Eagles. I don't believe it, the Canadian fans. Well, that's just a thing of beauty there from De Haas. Hope that photographer got that shot down the end there, because that is a beautiful score from the replacement nine.
Yeah.
Try number four for the US. They get a bonus point there, but most importantly, they keep their record intact against Canada. A massive finish to this game. Leader. Wants the extra two. Man playing with the Boston Free Jacks team in Major League Rugby 2020. Need a lovely kick from the replacement. Raises the flags. And that brings up full time as well. It's heartbreak for Canada. For 79 minutes, they were superb. But it's the United States. They keep their record. 9 wins out of 10. And it's been 6 years still. The last victory for Canada against the United States. After the break, we'll bring you post-match analysis from Starfire Sports Stadium, with the US victorious 30-25 against their rivals, Canada.
USA Rugby is on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, and YouTube. Connect with USA Rugby on social media, find game scores, tables, news, and the latest updates on rugby in America.
Join us back here on Sunday. That's this Sunday. Day after tomorrow, Sunday, March 10th, 5 p.m. Seattle Seawolves are back celebrating Pride Night as they get set to take on the visiting Houston SaberCats. Get tickets online tonight at SeattleSeaWolves.com.
Yeah, mic check, mic check, mic check.
And be sure to get home safely. And thank you for coming out to Starfire Sports Stadium to support rugby and your USA Eagles.
Well, we're here with Lucas Rumble, the captain, and Lucas, a brave, brave performance from Canada, but also disappointing for you.
Yeah, definitely credit to the boys. We stuck it in there, but the result didn't go our way.
What were some of the issues? You had a lot of defensive stands, but in the end, we weren't able to hold them out.
I think lots of piggybacks from us. I think we played a majority of the attacking rugby. We stuck in defensively. We stopped them, but we let them ride on our mistakes and our penalties all the way into points. So,
overall for this season, good steps forward for Canada.
Yeah, some good steps forward. Lots to work on still, but definitely a lot of bright spots.
All right, Lucas, thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Seattle, Washington. The U.S. Eagles have their 21st victory over Canada in match number 61 between these two great nations. Tonight's score, a thriller, 30-25 in favor of the U.S. Alex Goff, sideline with the Canadian captain.
Well, we're here with Lucas Rumble, the captain. And Lucas, a brave, brave performance from Canada, but also disappointing for you.
Yeah, definitely credit to the boys. We stuck it in there, but the result didn't go our way.
What were some of the issues? You had a lot of defensive stands, but in the end, we weren't able to hold them out.
I think lots of piggybacks from us. I think we played a majority of the attacking rugby. We stuck in defensively. We stopped them, but we let them ride on our mistakes and our penalties all the way to the points. So.
Overall for this season, good steps forward for Canada.
Yeah, some good steps forward. Lots to work on still, but definitely a lot of bright spots.
All right, Lucas, thank you.
Thank you.
And now let's hear from the winning captain of the United States of America.
Well, I'm here with Captain Blaine Scully. And Blaine, you really had to dig deep for that one.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's USA Canada, isn't it? It's always a contest for the full 80 minutes. And you know, they gave us everything we handled. And we did pretty well to stay in the fight for as long as we did. And sometimes you have to win it at the end.
You had some scoring opportunities that you didn't capitalize on, and then you came down with, you just had one more. You had to do this, didn't you?
I think it's pretty indicative of where we're at. Continue to unfortunately have a couple of unforced turnovers and some moments where we relieve pressure when really we start to get a foothold in the game. You know, we score points and we knock on a restart and then give them a high penalty. And it's been pretty indicative of this campaign and something that we need to tighten up as we head into the summer.
One more quick word about this crowd and this atmosphere.
It's a heck of a place to play. We've really enjoyed our time here in Seattle. I mean, what a hospitable bunch of fans who are really passionate about rugby, and we're just really grateful for all their support.
Blaine, thank you very much. Congrats.
As always, a tight one there. Final thoughts on this one, Brian?
Well, a ton of positives if you're a Canadian fan. The absolute work rate of this Canadian side from minute one all the way to the 80th minute, they were just flying into contact.
So thanks for joining us in Seattle, Washington, where the U.S. have defeated Canada by a score of 30-25 at Starfire Sports Stadium. For Brian Kelly, Alex Goff, and our entire crew, I'm Dylan Sanford saying thanks for watching.